Hello everyone, my name is Liz and I will be talking about Francophonie. You might have noticed some posters around school during this March talking about Francophonie. It is a concept regrouping the cultures that revolve around speaking French and not just in France. The idea first emerged in the late 19th century when a French geographer, Onésime Reclus, did research on the matter. By combining the Greek phonos, which means voice or sound, and the prefix franco, he made this phenomenon relevant on an international scale. Over the following century, that term has been used to unite 88 countries and governments around the same values. This amounts to 321 million French speakers around the globe, making French the fifth language spoken worldwide and the fourth language on the internet. The video that you can see on the slide comes from the OEF, the International Organization for Francophonie. It is available on their website to explain their missions and how they contribute to Francophonie. As stated before, Francophonie is a concept that regroups the countries, governments, and cultures that have a link with the French language. Promoting the language is therefore important, as languages carry with them history, and an international impact showcases power as well. Being a Francophone is about speaking French, from beginner to fluent, which is why among the 321 million French speakers are included the 144 million learners. It is also knowing about the variety behind French when it comes to music, food, places, and so on. So you, who have started to learn French when you were in year 7, or maybe before or after, can consider yourself a Francophone. Another aspect of a language is the difference here between the French language and speaking French. The French language is institutionalized by l'Académie Française since 1634. It protects the French language and helps face the dilemmas of new vocabulary coming through with various influences. On the other hand, speaking French will have more freedom and will be influenced by geographical, social, and cultural backgrounds, hence why French spoken in Quebec will be different from the one spoken in Mauritius. French is therefore really spread worldwide, mostly due to a history of colonization and globalization. The first man on the right is the most famous French navigator, Jacques Cartier, who has first set a French foot on American soil. The second one is Samuel de Champlain, who later helped to found Quebec. There are just two names in the sea of French navigators who explored the world. Centuries later, this led to 54 members of the OEF, 27 observers with French-speaking communities, and 7 associated states and governments who want to benefit from advantages in a course within the circle of Francophonie. To supervise those countries and the multiple exchanges between them, there was a need for institutions as early as 1926, which is when ADELF, a committee for French-speaking writers, came to life. The OEF, on the top right, can be considered as the main institution for this type of events and missions. Other organizations work around geopolitical decisions with Confemen and l'Assemblée parlementaire de la Francophonie, later leading to summits about development, university and academic networks with l'Agence universitaire de la Francophonie, and promoting the French language and cultural events via l'Alliance française et Institut français. Through those institutions and summits are taken decisions about challenges to tackle in a variety of fields. Major missions for the OEF include gender equality in Francophonie, granting women the same educational and job opportunities as their male peers, help in administration for cases such as civil status, census, and growth of local politics in remote areas, economic and commercial missions to facilitate trading accords and financial benefits between the member states of Francophonie, fighting against misinformation through educating people on how to watch out for fake news and how to recognize and analyze research and genuine information, promoting French-speaking artists through said institutions by giving them a platform to grow and build a network with, and teacher mobility, which allows the expatriation of French-speaking teachers from Francophonie to foreign countries and vice versa. Now going back to events in March, there were in total 592 events happening worldwide, which revolve around promoting cultures and arts, such as literature in Chad, cinema in Vietnam, and music in Austria. Each event is a result of those partnerships mentioned before to promote the French language on an international scale. Lastly, our school has been keen on celebrating Francophonie as well. Seth Barnes and his wonderful team were extremely helpful in promoting Francophonie through the interesting cuisines of Belgium, Tunisia, Mauritius, Senegal, and Lebanon. Mrs. Harcourt works very hard in class and on the French department's Twitter account as well, creating projects for our Year 9s, Year 10s, and Year 12s to discover French-speaking countries and film productions. Mr. Fascio and Mrs. Kwan have been working on poems and introducing Apollinaire's calligraphe to their Year 7s and Year 8s, which combine images and poetry. Overall, our continuous work throughout the year and the activities done in March allow students to know more about Francophonie and how much this quite recent term means. Thank you for listening, and we hope you have found this video interesting and enjoyable.